Vinland Saga may not be as well known as other animes, but it definitely should be. These are the reasons why you should check out Vinland Saga. Vinland Saga, among others, has proven through their quality and other attributes that this is one of the best anime to come out in 2019. In fact, the argument can be well made that Vinland Saga is among the best animes to come out in several years. It isn't like the bulk of the new animes that has to come out in the past years, and that is not at all a bad thing. In fact, this works to its favors. Having said that, here are the 10 reasons why you should watch Vinland Saga. On the 10th number, the reason is the setting of this anime. The first and the foremost is the setting. Setting is definitely one of the most important thing of the animes which makes or breaks that anime. Vinland Saga sets the stage by mostly taking place in the thousands in Nordic and when very much like into Vikings culture. Considering the Viking cultures is bathed into action and violence, to put it lightly, that makes for a very exciting and continuously engaging setting for anime fans. On the 9th number, the reason is it's more grounded than other lot of popular anime. For those who are fans of realism in their media or in any type of anime they watch, Vinland Saga is a must watch. Because Vinland Saga is relatively grounded story. With exceptions, of course, this means that those that are fans of more realistic but thrilling setting and stories like say Monster will likely appreciate Vinland Saga. Granted, the series takes creative liberties in areas like its action, for instance. Who can forget Thorkell the Tall's introduction where he absolutely throws off multiple soldiers with a single axe throw. But it is far more grounded setting and narrative compared to a lot of other popular animes and manga. On the 8th number, the reason to love Vinland Saga is it is a seinen masterpiece. It is fair to say that the anime and manga has proudly done a good job of managing to generally break into mainstream media, even outside of its country of origin, Japan. However, while not at all a negative judgment on anime or manga as a medium, it is also fair to say that a lot of popular series of this medium can be classified into shonen genre. That is anime and manga that is appealing to teens and all ages. In the shonen genre, multiple series comes to mind, with a few being My Hero Academia, Naruto, One Piece, etc. All great in their own right, but the seinen, that is anime and the manga geared more towards younger and older adults, don't get the same treatment, at least in the anime form. There are several seinen standouts, including amazing manga series like Berserk, Vagabond. Vinland Saga can stand in similar regards as a seinen genre masterclass, thanks to the Makoto Yukimura. On the 7th number, the reason is Thorfinn, which is the main character of the series, goes through a deep character development. This one doubles as in addition to why the anime is must watch out of all the anime series. Any good, thrilling and enthralling piece of media looking to achieve the status of this adjective must have a character development of their biggest character high on their to-do list. While we have seen only some character developments on Thorfinn's part in the first season, that is going from happy-go-lucky, optimistic, who just want nothing but vengeance. The story of Vinland Saga evolves over time and the Thorfinn evolves along with it. On the 6th number, the reason is there's more than one main character, for now I mean. Another big part of any anime media, including anime, is for the respective series to have a cast of characters that audience can get invested in. Vinland Saga definitely has that and will continue to have that in the future, whether the series get subsequent seasons or you read the manga ahead of the current anime. Right now, however, Vinland Saga is going through a very specific phase in these early arcs. In the anime, while Thorfinn is mainly just motivated by rage and revenge, he is taken more on the supporting role in the current arc. Possibly due to the fact that right now, Makoto Yukimura knows that he isn't very deep just yet. That's because right now it's mostly just about Asherald and later Canute. While Thorfinn takes time to develop as a character, Asherald proven himself to be an exciting, deep and interesting character. And sometimes people even loved Asherald more than our main character. On the 5th number, the reason is the action of the anime is intense and exciting. Makoto Yukimura anime and manga series Vinland Saga prides itself on being a lot of things. It is a seinen genre series. It is an intimate and personal story about a character facing odds and complications starting at the young age. It is also a grand story of adventure and war and turmoil of the continental proportions. However, having said that, it is or at least contains action as well as drama. Considering the time period the series takes place in and the Norse, Of course, it involves Viking culture, as I said in the start. The action is going to be a big focal point of the anime, especially so with the skilled warriors like Thorfinn, Asherald and Thorkell in the cast. Thankfully, when the action is built up and the reaches its climax, it is exciting as it is brutal. On the fourth number, the reason is the art of the manga and the animation of the anime. This, in part, also ties into the previous entry. Being the action is one example of the excellent work in art and animation. It engages the viewers, keeping them on the edge of their seats. The art and the animation can be different between the top tier and the bottom tier anime series. In fact, the same applies to any manga series minus the animation. Thus, well enough works in anime shouldn't be surprised that the art and animation are of a such high quality. After all, this is Attack on Titan Studio, which studio? On the third number, the reason is it is more than just a revenge story. Of course, Vinland Saga seems like your typical revenge story or plot if you all have been doing so far while watching the anime is focusing on Thorfinn solely. If so, that would be a mistake, as there are other characters in the series that are more than interesting and are helping drive the plot forward. Right now, Thorfinn is definitely only motivated by getting revenge for the death of his father, Thors, because of Asarel and Floki. However, right now we are seeing some great writing in character developments for Asherald and Kanyur. For those who read the manga, Thorfinn eventually grow into more than just an angry boy he is right now in the anime. On the second number, the reason is the pace of this anime. It's true that the very beginning of the series is a slow burn, but that doesn't equal bad. The story and the writing takes perfect amount of time in each episode to do world building and character developments. You take time to learn about how Thorfinn started a happy-go-lucky and inspired young boy to a revenge-driven teenager. The anime also takes time to set the scenes of the situation of the world the character occupies. The pacing allows for the perfect amount of time to develop the character, particularly so far Asherald and Canute right now. On the first number, the reason to love this anime is the score does well in setting the scene. The series score is beautifully well done and does well to complement the visuals of the series. Vinland Saga's music sets each scene perfectly and injects the appropriate amount of tension and emotional depending on the context of the scene. Some of the highlights of the series' use of the music or score is when the slower and more calm scenes where the soft piano is playing, emphasizing the emotional impact of the given scene. So yeah, these were the 10 reasons guys why you should watch Vinland Saga, and it is a must watch series. If you haven't watched Vinland Saga yet, you should do it right now. And if you have already watched Vinland Saga, leave your comments and opinions about Vinland Saga manga and anime in the comment section down below. I would like to know your opinions about this anime or manga, and subscribe to my YouTube channel because I post daily anime content about top 10, top 5 listings, anime reviews, recommendations, news, theories and all sort of anime content on daily basis. So if you enjoyed, please subscribe, and that was it, and I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.